Hello and welcome. In this session, we are going to explore how you may just find yourself at a point where you are more peaceful and stress-free. See, in this meditation session, we are going to explore how you may remove all those things that cause you stress in your life. And this can be achieved very easily, very effectively, by simply focusing on those things that make you stressful. And to achieve this, you will do a series of little exercises, thought exercises, that will help you to see the causes of your stress, of your anxiety, of all the things that take away from the happiness in your life. This we can do in each and every day of our lives to ensure that we are enjoying our lives, fulfilling ourselves, and making ourselves the best that we can be. So, let's begin by taking our position in a seated hold. Yes. Now, when you are ready and have taken your position, with your legs crossed and your spine erect and your head pointing straight up over your spine and your gaze slightly above your eye level until such time that your spine and your neck are aligned, to making sure that you have formed the perfect curvature on the bottom of your back so that you can enjoy this experience fully, and your gaze will automatically return to eye level. Ensure that your hands are gently folded above your navel. If you do so, you can also have your palms pointing upwards, your hands resting on your knees, and your thumb and index finger touching. And when you are ready, begin now. Take a deep breath in on a count of three. 1, 2, and 3. Hold it and release gently. 1, 2, and 3. And we're gonna repeat this again. 1, 2, 3. Hold it and release gently. 1, 2, 3. Now we're going to hold it for a count of three. So we begin 1, 2, 3 and hold. 1, 2, and 3. And now we release 1, 2, and 3. And I would like you to do it on your own count now, counting. And all you need to do is bring your attention to your breath, and it will bring you focus and concentration. Oftentimes, our minds are distracted, our minds are gazing and wandering out there, and our intentions and attention should be inside, in our own centeredness, on on our own gravity, in your own way of seeing life, rather than be distracted by all the things that are out there, taking away your attention, giving you what you should not be having, which is often stress and anxiety. And to remove the stress and anxiety, we have to look at our natural thoughts. You see, our conscious mind has been trained. We have been trained to perform. Ever since you were little, you have been taught to do things a certain way. Maybe it was your school, you had to get good grades. Maybe you had to perform well in sports, or maybe you had to perform well as a child. And maybe later on in life, you were expected to perform as a lover. Maybe you could not handle all that. At times you botched, you failed, and your failures might have left scars, might have left feelings of anxiety. Any time stress was high, you were expected to perform like a monkey in a circus. And now, seeing that there is a possibility of being someone who is carefree, who's centered and knows that everything in life will turn out for the best. All that needs to be done is to concentrate and put the attention on the things that are essential. Now, continue focusing on your breath, because our attentions often wander away, yet your attention can remain focused. And if you find yourself out of breath, notice how you are out of shape, controlling your breath, controlling your body. And if you at times feel that you are that has not had control over your life, then you may be right. Now you are on a path to taking control of your life. And what does stress mean? Stress means the performance that you are expected to do. If you don't feel that you are a failure, and that is not how it should be. We are all winners. We are all in this journey, and yet somehow we've been trained to perform. All these consequences. Yet, what does stress mean? Stress means that you are under pressure. And yet, imagine yourself, whatever you had to do, you could do it in a very long stretch of time. Then it will lose all that glorious, haunting feeling. Imagine if you had to do a writing, you could take 6 months to do it. Or if you could choose to be yourself. Maybe you don't have to do the things that you're expected to do out of all those people around you. Yes, I know there are consequences. Yet, you know that the stress and anxiety could dissipate. Just simply remove some of the burdens over your shoulders. Maybe you don't have to do the things that you need to do. Take on all those responsibilities, all those pressures upon yourself. Maybe you could tell your lover, your partner, that you don't feel like cooking tonight, that you don't feel like doing the things that you are expected to do, that you're going to take a chance on spending time for yourself, that they should respect that. Yes, I know that they might want to punish you for that, because you are trained, you are conditioned to respond like a monkey in a circus. And yet, the new boundaries of your existence need to be drawn. And for that, a battle must be waged, a war must be fought. And that is the stillness, saying, I will not do what has been expected of me. I will not say the things that I'm expected to say. I will only speak my mind when the time comes. I will do the things that I will do in my own time, in my own way, and at the work that I have, I will just take things one at a time, and when there are too many, I will just leave them for another day. And if they are not happy, they are not happy with that, then they will have to see that I am doing things the way I personally can. That means you are your own boss. You are the one who chooses to live your life the way you see it, rather than taking on more and more, expecting to be performed, expecting that you deliver results when you don't need to. You simply may choose that if you are not happy with your work, you can always quit. I know there are consequences, yet the choices are there. And sometimes those choices are not the easy ones, yet they bring us to junctions in our lives that we decide what is right, what is wrong. Maybe there are many, many other doors that will open with opportunities for happiness and fulfillment and joy if you are to make changes about the things that don't bring you happiness. If it's your job, maybe it's time for you to quit, find a new path. And if it's your lover, partner, maybe it's time to say, we need new rules, new boundaries. If they're not happy with that, maybe it's time for you to part. Maybe it's time for you to see that there are other things that may bring you fulfillment and joy. And look at your past. How many times have you thought that you really needed something? And then years later, you look at it and go, how foolish of me to be so fixated on something, or to think that a lover or a partner would be the end of your loneliness, only to see that it has crumbled away and that you find yourself in a new relationship. And perhaps you know that you are more prudent, wiser than the past, so that you can make better decisions. And now I invite you to see that your current relationship and your past relationships are preparing you for your next one, so that you may find fulfillment, that you may grow. And if you're not growing, then you are taking the precious time that you have seeing the things that make us unhappy, staring it right at the cause and making a decision to say that you will not do it. You will not take it upon yourself to perform, because you are yourself. You are the one who is at the helm of your destiny. You yourself must take time for yourself to meditate, to find ways to remain focused, to concentrate, so that you know yourself to be the center, grounded, so that you know you will have happiness at your doorstep. Now I want you to concentrate on your breath again, because again, you might have drifted away from your concentration. And remember, it takes 21 days for a habit to form, a habit of listening and concentrating and remaining focused. So make this your journey. Make a journey and commitment to yourself that you will listen to this recording for 21 days and repeat this process over and over again, the same time every day, so that you yourself can find focus and concentration, and more importantly, clarity about your life, because all life is about distraction. Distraction from the realities, distraction from the real causes of anxiety. That's right. Again, concentrate on your breath and see that there was a time, a long time ago, that people could do away without having cellular phones. Maybe it's time to realize that you can turn off your phone sometimes, that you don't have to answer those calls. There was a time when emails didn't need to be sent. Post and mail would arrive. And that, again, is how it should be. You should be able to say to yourself, I will not answer those emails. I will not check upon those emails. And if you find yourself under the pressure, you'll say, my thoughts are repeating the actions that have brought me stress and anxiety. I will do everything to stop it. And do something. Play with something. Go out, take a walk, until those habits that you had formed in the past dissipated, are no longer habits, but things that you had done without realizing the harm that it has caused you. Now, look at your life from beginning to end, from the earlier days of your childhood until now. What a journey it has been. You have been foolish. You have done things to hurt others, maybe. And you have done things that you felt guilty about. And that was just a journey. Because you, along the way, have learned things about yourself. And you have thought things to others about themselves. So now ask yourself, would you take everything back? Would you change things that have been your guidance, your learning experience? If your answer is yes, that means you have to work on those things that you felt guilty about, things that you felt you didn't have to do. Yet those are all in the past. You have to make peace with those things. And if you're fine with the things that you have done, then it's time for you to look at yourself and see that your future will also have failures and errors and mistakes. Yet they're all fine, because we are not perfect beings. We are perfect beings in ourselves as we journey through our lives, because we are aligned to the future, and our process is filled with learning experiences, and those learning experiences guide us in becoming more mature, more evolved, more enlightened, more peaceful, more loving. If you have found yourself to be bitter and angry, you are the only one to blame. You are the only one who has caused yourself harm. Yet today, in this meditation session, you are undoing all those knots, all those things that you have weaved over the years, causing you to be stressful and feeling anxiety. And now, I invite you to say to yourself, make a commitment, and every day, morning and evening, make it a time, and make it a time that you will do things repetitiously. When you're eating, before you eat, maybe the time when you're taking a shower, you say to yourself that very simple thing: I release my anger, I release my anxiety, and I embrace happiness. You repeat this 12 times. And those 12 times, make sure you mean it in every time. And the things will begin to work, because your unconscious processes yourself will hear those words and know what to do with it. You don't have to know what to do. Your unconscious mind, your guiding spirit guides you. You will find ways in which you can be happier, more peaceful, more joyful. And all that needs to be done is repetition. That's why monks meditate year after year, till an old age, find enlightenment, because they see the big game, the madness, the craziness that this life is. Yet it's only like a movie that you are part of. You watch yourself, you see yourself, the things that happen around you, and you are just a player in this game. Life can be filled with joy, because there are so many lives happening at the same time. Yet each life is unique. Each life has many, many, many layers. And now, their journeys are as important as yours. But your journey, your responsibility is to yourself. You are the guiding light that must must shed light upon others, bring awareness and joy into their lives, so that you may also receive joy. When someone causes pain and suffering, they too are suffering, because suffering is contagious. So is happiness. So if you are with friends who are joyful and happy, you will be affected by them. Yet if you watch yourself watching violence on TV, seeing stress all around you and anxiety, you too will be affected by this. So I invite you to notice the consequences of your actions. And now, once again, bring your attention to your breath, because you would have drifted again from the concentration that you should be holding. And breathe deeply, strongly, and releasing slowly, slowly, making sure that every muscle that you hold tension in your body is relaxing. You're letting go, going deeper and deeper into a state of utter clarity, utter self-knowledge, seeing that actions that you have taken in the past, causing you the harm and suffering, now changing the process and refusing to accept those circumstances which make you sad, which make you feel less than the best that you can be. And if you need to make changes, it's about time that you do so. Yet you don't need to rush to make those changes. Take your time, meditate upon them. Meditate upon the purpose of your life and see that the changes you will be making are the changes that you see are necessary, and then they become gifts to yourself. And what better way to give a gift to yourself that brings you happiness day after day? Ever thought about how your life might have been if you have made certain decisions in the past? And I invite you to look at yourself. Imagine a future when you have made these changes that you are going to make to improve your life. How much more happiness there would be, how carefree you would be, how fulfilled you would be, how nice everything will mean to you. And maybe it in your destiny, when one door closes, many more doors open. That's the bounty of life. And if you trust life, life will bring you all those wonderful things, because life is full of opportunities, and it's our responsibility to see those opportunities and render them accessible to ourselves. Now, take a moment, silence, and say, thank myself for seeing things in more clarity, and bring the gift of clarity to myself. Repeat after me. I thank myself for bringing clarity into my life and helping me to see things clearly. That's right. You have to be thankful. You have brought yourself to this listening, and I have brought you a gift. gift of seeing things more clearly. Now return the gift to others so that they may too see their own ways. Maybe you offer them this recording, which is free, which is something that you can easily share with others. Or you might just decide that the first thing you need to do is give it to the ones that are closest to you, so that they too see your path, your journey to becoming a more happy, peaceful person. And this doesn't cost anything. It's only a state of mind. It's only a way of looking at things. And believe me, there is much suffering in this world, and you are the one who can end it today by saying that you will make fundamental changes and do away with things that bring you unhappiness. Now we are going to bring this session to a close by a simple chant. You to do is to take a deep breath within me, with me, so that we can chant the three words, peace, 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 and in the Sanskrit, it is shanti, shanti, shanti. So we begin. Take a deep breath in, hold it, and hold. Peace, 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 shanti, shanti, shanti. Feel how your lungs vibrate, how the energy in your body vibrates when you say those words. I thank you for listening. See you in the next session.